Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. This week we're in Austin, Texas for the Computer-Human Interaction Conference, where we got a glimpse of the future. That'll have to wait a moment, though, as we get to this week's top stories. A jury found that Google did infringe on Oracle patents when it developed Android, but it couldn't unanimously decide if that fell under fair use. After a week of deliberation, it's a partial victory for Oracle, but they'll have to wait longer to see whether Google will escape liability for its claim of fair use. Google's attorney immediately told the judge that Google would file for a mistrial, arguing that the same jury must decide both verdicts. We'll, of course, keep you posted. Yahoo has formed a committee to investigate the hiring of CEO Scott Thompson after revelations came that the second major listed on his resume proved false. Thompson's biography on the Yahoo website and in papers filed with the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission said that he had majored in accounting and computer science. Thompson, in fact, only majored in accounting. Now on to some of the cool projects here at the Computer-Human Interaction Conference in Austin. We first showed you Zero Touch last year, but this year it's bigger and more responsive. Zero Touch uses an array of IR sensors to create a mesh of invisible light. When the beams are broken, the system interprets that as a point of contact.
Last year, the biggest sensor we showed was 27 inches, and this year we're able to, build Zero Touch, integrate Zero Touch with a 55-inch television, which is, we think, a really valuable market because our technology scales with cost linearly, whereas the capacitive touch sensing used in the iPhone and iPad scales with the square of linear area, basically.
The team showed a number of applications for Zero Touch, like this multiplayer game. On this screen, the spectator can select different views and swing around the action. Researchers said for a 55-inch TV that costs around $1,500, adding Zero Touch would bring the total price to around $2,100. Zero Touch is selling developer kits that start at $2,000 and is looking for partners to eventually bring the product to market. A project called IllumiShare lets users share their physical desktop with other users anywhere in the world. The lampshade-looking device houses a projector and a camera. Both sides stay in sync. What's written on one side is projected onto the other, but it presents the problem of visual feedback, where the video would repeat in an endless loop. To solve that, researchers made sure the camera and projector were never both on at the same time.
To alternate the camera and the projector, to time multiplex them and not see visible flicker, we have to do that at 60 hertz. And we're using only a 60 hertz small pocket-sized projector. So what we had to do is basically simulate 120 hertz where this is going to alter back and forth. Now when you do that, you're basically stealing time from the projector. And if you steal too much time, the projected image is not going to be very bright. So the amount of time we were able to steal was only 4 milliseconds or so in our current setup with our current hardware. And because we have a webcam cannot take a really good image with only 4 milliseconds of shutter time. So as an additional piece of an additional component we have in the system is an LED array that acts like a camera flash.
He said IllumiShare could work over Skype, but the quality would be dependent on bandwidth. The project has been in the works for about a year and a half, and researchers now plan to study how consumers and enterprises could use IllumiShare. The team is building 40 units and shipping them to Microsoft offices worldwide to let developers and designers connect conference rooms and workstations. Go ahead and tilt your laptop screen and watch the colors change. It's that annoyance that one CHI researcher has turned into a feature. Called Dual View, it's strictly software-based. There's no hardware or filters needed for the screen.
The well-known optical property of this LCD, cheap LCDs, when you look at different angles, you will see the colors start to change a little bit. We're actually exploiting this property by using a special algorithm to render the image in a special way so that we can hide or show different images at different angles. We're basically making a bug into a feature.
There are a variety of uses for the technology, ranging from privacy to gaming to even potential 3D applications. There are no immediate plans for commercialization, though. When you think of gesture sensing and Microsoft, Kinect comes to mind. But two former Microsoft research interns have come up with a new way to gesture sense that doesn't need cameras at all. A project called Soundwave uses a computer's speaker and microphone to sense hand motions.
So what SoundWave does is it generates an inaudible ultrasonic tone between the range of 18 to 22 kilohertz, higher if your sound card supports it. And it emits that ultrasonic tone and it gets bounced off your hand.
Gupta has mapped 5 gestures to computer actions and said the system could probably support up to 10, but all of them need to be motion-based. Static gestures won't work. Here, Gupta can flip through a set of images or play and pause a clip on YouTube. Another gesture sensing project is Humantenna, which can register whole body motion without any sort of external capturing device. Rather than have accelerometers all over your body, users only need to wear a device like this, which is a little larger than a wristwatch. Movements can be interpreted and paired with actions on a computer. Both Humantenna and SoundWave are research projects, so there are no immediate plans for commercialization. Here's a unique experiment. This cheese cube and fork are attached to a battery. This little switch changes the amount of electricity flowing through the fork, which changes the taste of the cheese. Another demonstration used lemonade, which I thought worked pretty well. As electricity was added, the taste changed. Researchers think that electricity might be able to replace salt in food and hopefully help people live healthier lives. Another possibility is taste sharing. The captured waveform could be shared with a friend who could then replicate the electricity and share the taste of a food or drink. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. To find out what's coming up on every week's show, be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. One programming note, next week I'll be out, so I'll see you in 2 weeks. As we head out, we'll leave you with some sights of CHI. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.